بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I welcome you to another episode of our series As-Safarat al-Kiram, where we strive to be with the holy angels by reciting the Quran properly. I'm your host, Abu Ammar Yasir Qadhi. Generally, jealousy is a very evil characteristic. However, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in specific circumstances, encouraged us to be jealous. Of these circumstances is, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا حسد إلا فتنتين. No one should be jealous of anyone else except in two circumstances. The first of them, he said, is a man whom Allah has blessed with money, and he spends that money for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. So he is very generous with his money. And the second of them is a person whom Allah has blessed with the book. He has blessed, in other words, to memorize the Quran, to understand it, and so he recites it all the time, day and night. So in this particular case, we should be jealous. What is the meaning of jealousy here? The meaning of jealousy is we want to be like that person. Not that we wish any harm for him, no. That type of jealousy is never allowed. The type of jealousy that the Prophet ﷺ wanted us to have is to be like that person. We want to be rich in order to spend money. Not to be rich to live like a luxurious king or something, no. And we want to have the Quran and to memorize the Quran in order to recite it properly, recite it with a good voice. In yet another hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said that part of showing glory to Allah, in other words, part of being a perfect believer, is to show respect to three people. The first is to a white-haired Muslim, an old Muslim, a person who has grown up in Islam, has lived his entire life in Islam. The second, hamilul Qur'an, the carrier of the Qur'an. The carrier of the Qur'an, the one who has memorized the Qur'an, has understood it and acted upon it. The one who, the Prophet ﷺ said, neither does he go to one extreme nor to the other. He is a moderate person. And the third is a just ruler. A ruler who rules justly according to the law of Islam. So it is a part of our worship of Allah Azza wa Jal that we show respect to those that have properly memorized, understood and acted upon the Qur'an. Returning to our topic of the rules of Tajweed, we now move on to a completely new set of rules, and that is the rules of Mad, or the elongation of the vowel letters. And we're going to spend a number of episodes on this. So this is the first of our series of rules regarding the elongation of the vowel letters. This is of many types and categories. So bear with me, point by point. As I said over and over again, Tajweed is not a confusing science. It just takes a little bit of understanding and a little bit of practice. You just have to be patient and take each rule as it comes. All it is simple memorization and application. So the first type of elongation is a natural mad, a natural elongation, okay? And mad means to elongate, to make something long. A natural mad occurs when one of the letters of mad is not followed by or preceded by a hamza or sukun. Okay, so let's ponder over this definition. What is a natural mad, a natural elongation? It occurs when the letter of mad. Now, what is the letter of mad? We discussed this in an earlier episode. Some of you are a little bit confused. I knew this would happen, therefore I have it right here. Okay, the letters of mad are the ya, which is preceded by a kasra, e, the wa, which is preceded by a dhamma, oo, and the alif, which is preceded by a fatha, ah, the three vowel sounds. These are the three letters of the mad. A, e, u. Notice that you cannot have a haraka on the ya, wa, or alif itself, or else it would not be a letter of the mad. Ya, yi, you, this is not a letter of mad. Only e, which is the ya, which doesn't have any letter on it. But it any haraka, any sign on it, but it has a kasra before. Likewise the waw and likewise the alif. So let us go back to our definition. A natural mad occurs when one of these three letters, e, u, a, is not followed by or preceded by, neither before or after it, is a hamza or sukun. Okay? So basically it's natural because that's how it's supposed to be. Natural state of mind, natural frame. You don't have any hamza, you don't have any sukun, before or after. This type of mad is the most common type of mad. Every second word in the Quran has it. Some words have more than yani two mads in even one word. Okay? The ruling is that you prolong this to two harakas. You prolong it to two harakas. What is a haraka?
Half a second.
It's the length or the time it takes to open a finger from a closed fist. So one haraka, and then one, two harakas. One, two. Okay? The haraka is the unit of length invented by the scholars of Tajweed to tell you how long to pronounce the vowel sounds and the ghunnas. So the first example we'll look at is this word, yaquluna. Here we have a waw preceded by a dhamma, likewise a waw preceded by a dhamma. Two waws here, both of which are preceded by dhammas. Notice, yaquluna. You don't say yaquluna. You have to make it long. If you didn't make the mad, you would not hear the letter of mad, the waw before the dhamma. Yaquluna. Likewise, it's a mistake to make it longer than two. Yaquluna. That's a mistake. It has to be two harakas, okay? Yaquluna. This is the way that you judge it. Now, obviously, in the beginning, you might have to physically do this to time yourself, but eventually you get into the art of figuring out yourself how long it is. Also, by listening to famous qaris, you will also get a good idea of how much two harakas is. Likewise, in the second word, qala, same thing, qala. This is the mad, the natural mad. Qala. Over here, qila. There's a ya preceded by a kasra. Qila. In the fourth word, irji'u. Here's the waw, and there's a dhamma on top of it. Irji'u. Irji'u. You have it for two harakas. Here, ya hamanu, ya hamanu. We have all three cases of alifs preceded by fathas. So we have three letters of mad. Ya hamanu. It is a mistake to go longer. Ya ha. No, you don't do that. It has to be two harakas only. All of these examples, the last one, al-mizan, same thing. Al-mizan, we have the ya and the alif, both of them. The ya preceded by a kasra and the alif preceded by a fatha, two harakas. Notice, in none of these examples is there a hamza or a sukun. This is the key. Anytime there is no hamza or sukun, before or after the letter of mad, this is a natural mad. And there is one word which easily, if you memorize it, you will understand the rule, and that is this word, Nuhiha. You notice all of the letters of the mad are included here. The waw before it is a dhamma, the ya before it is a kasra, and the alif before it is a fatha. Nuhiha. All of these three letters of mad are combined in this one word. So anytime there is a letter of mad which has no hamza and no sukun close to it, before or after it, then you must prolong it two harakas. This is the natural mad. This is what is known as a natural mad. Okay. Let us move on to some other types which are easy and they have the same ruling. Then there are other types of mad as well, and we're going to discuss these in a number of episodes. The first type we'll go on to is a replacement mad. We call it in Arabic al-mad al-iwad. You replace something with something else. What do you replace? You replace two fathas with a mad sound if you stop upon it. Okay? And this is something, alhamdulillah, everybody knows, that when you stop on two fathas, anywhere there's fathatain, two fathas, you stop on it, then you must replace that with an alif, basically, which is a mad. For example, these are some examples we have. Afuwan qadira. Suppose you were to stop on the afuwan. You wouldn't say afu. You say afuwa. You stop with the alif. Suppose you stop on the qadira. Afuwan qadira. Qadira. Notice the D. What type of mad is this?
Natural
mad. Qadi. The ra. This is the mad which is a mad al-iwad. Anytime you have two fathas, you stop on it, then it becomes a natural mad. If you don't stop, then obviously you move on with the rules of tanween that we've done. Afuwan qadira. We didn't stop here. What type of hukum, what type of ruling applies here?
Ikhfa.
We did this in a previous episode. Over here, afwaja. What type of mad is the first alif?
Natural
mad. What type of mad is the second alif?
Replacement.
Mad al-iwad. Replacement mad. Likewise, nisa'a. Notice here, this is an alif followed by a hamza. We haven't discussed this mad yet. Okay, we'll get there later on. But the point is the hamza has a tanween, so we changed the tanween into an alif. Nisa'a, like this. Another type is a substitution, a mad al-badal. And this occurs when one of the letters of the mad is followed or occurs after a hamza. So there's a hamza and then you have the letter of the mad. In this case, this two is of two harakas. Some examples are amanu, imana, and utu. Now, amanu, you might think, where is the hamza? That's why I have it in brackets here. Actually, amanu is a hamza followed by an alif. So here's the alif preceded by a fatha, which is a hamza. This is called mad al-badal. This is also of two harakas. Amanu. You don't say amanu. Same thing with iman. You have a letter of mad, which is the ya, preceded by a kasra, which happens to be a hamza. So the same ruling of two harakas applies. And lastly, utu. You have a waw, preceded by a dhamma, and the dhamma happens to be on the hamza. Once again, it is two harakas. So basically, we have three types of mad that we discussed in today's episode. We'll discuss more later on. All of these three mads have only two harakas. You don't make them longer than this. The first type was the natural mad, when it's not followed by any hamza, any sukun. The second type is the replacement mad, which is you convert two fathas into a natural mad, okay? And you also do that two harakas. And the third type was the substitution mad, where a hamza occurs before the mad. Amanu, iman, and utu. So let me now recite some verses for you, and if you follow along. Let us choose Surah An-Nazi'at. Surah An-Nazi'at is the, as you know, second surah in Juz Amma, surah number 79.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والنازعات غرقا.
Okay, who can tell me what the mads are? Where's the first mad?
Nazi'a.
What type of mad?
Natural
mad. Because there's an alif preceded by a fatha. Second,
aati.
Same type, right? Gharqa. What type is this? This is the
replacement.
The replacement mad. Because you have replaced two fathas with a harf al mad, or the letter of mad.
وَالنَّاشِطَاتِ نَشْطَى.
Same thing over here. The na is the natural. Ta, once again, is the natural. Nashta, we have over here the replacement or maddul al-iwad. Now, again, with the alifs here, the na was a light alif. Remember, we're going to emphasize this a lot because, once again, this is a very, very common error that people don't know how to pronounce the alifs properly. They make heavy alifs light and they make light alifs heavy, and this is a mistake. They pronounce one nashitati, nashitati, which is a mistake. It's nashitati. Okay? Nashta, once again, should be heavy because the letter before it is heavy.
وَالنَّاشِطَاتِ نَشْطًا وَالسَّابِحَاتِ سَبْحًا فَالسَّابِقَاتِ سَبْقًا فَالْمُدَبِّرَاتِ أَمْرًا.
Once again, throughout these ayat, we have the same types of examples that we have سَابِحَات. What type? Two types of natural mad, right? سَبْحَا. Once again, we have
replacement.
فَالسَّابِقَاتِ سَبْقَى. Exact same. Two naturals and one replacement. فَالْمُدَبِّرَاتِ. Here we have the رَات is the natural. And then أَمْرَى is the replacement.
يَوْمَ تَرْجُفُ الرَّاجِفَةِ تَتْبَعُهَا الرَّادِفَةِ قُلُوبٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ وَاجِفَةِ أبصارها خاشعة يقولون أئنا لمردودون في الحافرة.
Now all of these have been the same, replacement or natural. Okay, so there's nothing new over here. Just again emphasize where the alifs have to be heavy and light. يومئذٍ واجفة is light. أبصارها. صَا is heavy and ها is light. Okay. Let us now move on to an example where there will be something new. Let us see. We are now trying to find a special type of mad. Okay, here we go.
أَإِذَا كُنَّا عِظَامًا نَخِرَةً قَالُوا تِلْكَ إِذًا كَرَّةٌ خَاسِرَةٌ فَإِنَّمَا هِيَ زَجْرَةٌ وَاحِدَةٌ فَإِذَا هُمْ بِالسَّاهِرَةِ هَلْ أَتَاكَ حَدِيثُ مُوسَى.
Now once again, there's nothing special in these things. We all have the same types of alifs and the same types of substitution. We have the same type of replacement where we take a double fatha and we convert it to a normal med. Okay, here we have a different type which we haven't done before. It's verse number 18. فَقُلْ هَلْ لَكَ إِلَىٰ أَن تَزَكَّى. Okay, we have here an alif followed by a hamza. We haven't done this yet, so just remember this is something we're going to do in the next episode. Let us move on a few verses to find another example that we can use. Let us move on to verse 18 right now.
فَقُلْ هَلْ لَكَ إِلَىٰ أَن تَزَكَّى وَأَهْدِيَكَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ فَتَخْشَى فَأَرَاهُ الْآيَةَ الْكُبْرَى.
Okay, notice here, we have لَكَ إِلَىٰ أَن. Now I waited very long, and you notice because there's a hamza after it. So this is a rule we haven't done before, because there's a hamza after the harf mad. So wait till a few episodes, we'll discuss this. وَأَهْدِيَكَ. Notice here the ya. You might think there's a ya before it is a kasra, there will be a mad. But no. What was the condition? We said that the ya itself, sakin, it cannot have any letter on it. So it's very important that you don't get confused. The letter of mad must not have any haraka on it. Okay? Then we go on. فَأَرَاهُ الْآيَةَ الْكُبْرَى. Aha, I made a mad here. What type of mad is this?
Substitution.
This is a maddul badal, a substitution mad, because there is a ya preceded by a hamza. So we went two mads.
فَأَرَاهُ الْآيَةَ الْكُبْرَى.
This is a two haraka, because it is a ya, an alif preceded by a hamza.
فَكَذَّبَ وَعَصَى ثُمَّ أَدْبَرَ يَسْعَى.
Okay, let's analyze a few mudud here. We have هَلْ لَكَ إِلَىٰ أَن. We have a harf mad, but it's followed by
hamza.
A hamza. So we haven't discussed this rule yet. So we'll move on and discuss it in the next episode. أَن تَزَكَّى. This is a natural mad. Okay. وَأَهْدِيَكَ. Notice the أَهْدِيَكَ. It's a very interesting point here. The ya is preceded by a kasra, right? Does this make it a mad?
No.
No. Because?
Because ya has a haraka.
The ya has a haraka on it. And we said that for a letter to be a letter of mad, there can be no haraka. There can't be any fatha, kasra, dhamma. So there is no mad over here.
فَأَرَاهُ الْآيَةَ الْكُبْرَى.
Ayah. What type of mad is this?
Substitution,
because there is an alif before it is a fatha, but the fatha happens to be on
hamza.
A hamza. Okay, so the substitution mad is just like a natural mad, except that there's a hamza before it. The only thing is you call it something different. Otherwise, it's the same ruling of two harakas. فَكَذَّبَ وَعَصَى. Same thing. It is a natural mad. ثُمَّ أَدْبَرَ يَسْعَى. Natural mad. فَحَشَرَ فَنَادَى. Two natural mads. فَقَالَ. Natural mad. أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْأَعْلَى. Once again, natural mad. We get on to فَأَخَذَهُ اللَّهُ. By the way, the word Allah also has a mad.
Yes.
Allahu, it's a natural mad. نَكَالَ الْآخِرَةِ. Here's the point. آخِرَةِ. What type of mad?
Substitution.
Substitution. And أُولَى.
Substitution
as well. We have an alif preceded by a fatha, and the fatha happens to be on the hamza. So it becomes substitution. Same thing with al-ula. We have a waw preceded by a dhamma, and the dhamma happens to be on a hamza. Therefore, it becomes a
substitution
mad. So the rulings of the mudu that we did today were basically three. We have the natural mad, which is where you have one of the letters of the mad, which is not preceded by a hamza or sukoon. And this is the most common type. You have it in every single ayah in the Quran. Every second, third word has a natural mad in it. If it is preceded by a hamza, we don't call it a natural mad. Rather, we call it a maddul badal. But the ruling is still the same. It is two harakas. And one last thing that we discussed today, if you stop at a place where there are two tanweens, two fathas, we call them in Arabic, yani fathatain, two fathas, one on top of the other, if you stop there, then it becomes a natural mad. So these are the rulings of today. Inshallah, in the next episode, we'll continue discussing other types of mudud. I hope to see you then. Until next time, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.